Hi everyone, this is Vishu Agarwal, Senior Corporate Trainer at Koenig Solutions, and today I'm going to talk about After Effects. I'm going to talk about what is the difference between orientation and rotation. So when you switch your layers in After Effects to 3D layers, you might have noticed that you get two options of rotation. So let's get started. So here I'm in After Effects on 18, and as you can see, I have two boxes here, which is one is in blue color and one is in the yellow color you have. So these are basic two shapes I have. And if I make them 3D in After Effects, and if you see the rotation of both the layers, you are seeing the two options eventually. So you see rotation and the orientation over here. So what is the difference between it? Initially, when you use these properties to rotate, you might not notice any difference between them. So for example, so if I rotate this yellow one in the z-axis, you can see that it's rotating 360 degrees like that, right? So it's going from left to the right rotation. And if I do the same thing for the below one, the rotation of the z-direction, so you can see it's doing the same stuff. So initially, when you scrub the properties of orientation and rotation in any of these axes, it looks the same. But they make a lot of difference when you do the animation. And that's what I'm just going to show you. So I will take layer number one, which is my blue one, and I will animate its orientation. Whereas in the yellow one, I'm going to animate its rotation. So let's take shape number one, which is the blue one. And I set the keyframe on the initial frame, on the starting of the timeline. And go ahead up to last of my timeline at the end and change this value to 280. So I'm not making 360 because there's a reason for that. Why I'm not making 360 is because when you set 360, it automatically goes to zero. You have to also notice that. So I'm gonna make it 280. I will do the same thing for the yellow box, but in the Z rotation, not in orientation. So I will just animate its stopwatch over here. Go ahead in my timeline till the end and change this to a same value of 280. Right. So both are rotating. Initially, if you see, both of them look in the same way. But what's the real difference? Let's see if you can spot it. So I'm going to play this timeline and closely watch both the boxes. So I'm going to play it. Let me just deselect that and hit play. So it's playing at a little slower rate, but now it's real time when it goes through and scrubs through it. I don't know if you will notice the difference. If you see this rotation, in the difference of the animation is, the yellow one is going clockwise, whereas the blue one is going in the opposite direction, anti-clockwise. Because this property, it's kind of a lazy property, you know. It says, okay, I have to reach to 280 value, and if I go clockwise, it will be far enough for me. So let's go anti-clockwise. And when it goes anti-clockwise, it can reach that value easier, right? With fewer animation, it goes and starts rotating in the anti-clockwise state. Whereas the yellow one follows the rotation and goes in the clockwise direction. So that's the major difference which you see when you animate it, right? One more thing, if you set this to 360, like I said before, this value to 360, you will see that at the end, it will go to zero. So which means there will be no animation from this keyframe to this keyframe. Whereas if you make this one 360, you will notice that you have a one in the multiplier. That means one 360 rotation in the set of keyframes you have defined. So it will rotate 360 degrees complete clockwise, whereas this one, the blue box, does not rotate at all because both the keyframe have a value of 0 and 0. So why is there orientation given in After Effects for 3D, where it might look a little useless when you have rotation, right? So for that, I have another composition over here. And let's say this is just for an example, a simple example. Let's say where you have equal to sign over here, right? And you also have this V, which is basically less than or greater than you can call. And so what I will do is I want to rotate this to 360 degrees, but the person who have created this sign has created like a V shape. So I've created through text a V shape. And now I want to rotate it to create a sign of greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the orientation for that purpose, because I want to also animate to 360 degrees. Also want to set it pose. So for setting a pose, you use orientation over here. So what I mean is that what I will do is I'm going to rotate this to create a sign of it like this. So maybe I want 270. So that's the value which I need over here. So you can see initially I've set the pose. Now I want to rotate at 360 degrees and stop at the same position. So what I can do now is I can go to the Z rotation and go over here to the end and change it to 360. I can just type a value of 360 over here, or I can simply say 1. So 1 also means the same thing, that a round of 360 degrees one time between your keyframes. So if I play this now, you will see it will start rotating from that particular space and going to complete one 360 degree circle and end at the starting. So it was catching the frames. Now you will see the animation was smoother, but you can see it take a 360 degrees rotation over here now and ends at the end of the pose, which you have set in the rotation value. Right, so always use orientation as a value of setting the pose of your initial character you have, or any initial layer or objects you have in your composition, and use rotation values for the animation. I hope that makes you clear about orientation and rotation. Thank you so much.